Now that we understand the high-level goal of GMS, the most important parameter in the working of GMS system is age management, because we need to identify what is the globally oldest page whenever we want to do replacements. And let's see how that algorithm works and how it is managed. So in any distributed system, one of the goals is to make sure that any management work is not bringing down the productivity of that node. In other words, you want to make sure that management work is distributed and not concentrated on any one node. And you know, in the GMS system, since we are working with an active set of nodes, over time, the node that is active may become inactive, and a node that was inactive may become active, and so on. And so you don't want the management of age information to be assigned to any given node, but it is something that has to shift over time. And that's sort of the fundamental tenet of building any distributed system, is to make sure that we distribute the management work so that no single node in the distributed system is overburdened with that. That's a general principle, and we will see how that principle is followed in this particular system. So we break the management both along the space axis and time axis into what is called epochs. And there are two parameters that govern an epoch. One is T, which is the maximum duration of an epoch. That is, an epoch is in some sense the granularity of management work done by a node. And that management work done by a node is either time-bound, maximum T duration, or space-bound, maximum M replacement. So if in the working of the system, if M page replacements have happened, then that epoch is complete, so we go to a new epoch. There'll be a new manager for age management. Or if the duration T is complete, then again, the epoch is complete, and so we pick a new manager to manage the next epoch. And we'll see in a minute how we pick a new manager. And T may be on the order of a few seconds, and M, which is the number of replacements, may be on the order of thousands of replacements. So at the start of each epoch, what happens is every node is going to send the age information to the initiator. That is, every node is going to say, what is the age of the pages that is resident at this node? All the local pages, all the global pages, the universe of all the pages that exist at this node, what is the age information associated with that? And remember that the smaller the age, the more relevant the pages. So the higher the age, the older the page. So in picking a candidate, we're always going to pick an old page to replace. So that's the age information that each of these node is sending to the initiator. So N1 sends its set of pages, N2 sends its set of pages, and so on. Everybody is sending to the manager node that I'm calling the initiator, the age information. What the initiator node is going to do is two things. It's going to find out what is the minimum age of all the M pages that are going to be replaced. Remember that smaller the age, the better. So what it is going to say is, out of all the pages that exist in the entire cluster, what are the oldest M pages that are going to be replaced in the upcoming epoch? And for those M old pages, out of those M old pages, what is the minimum age? So any page with less than the minimum age are pages that are active and that are going to survive this upcoming epoch. Whereas any page whose age is older than that minimum age is part of this set of M pages that are going to be replaced in the upcoming epoch, and those are the replacement candidates. That's minimum age. So it computes that minimum age, and it also computes, given the minimum age and given the distribution of the age demographics coming from N1, I know out of these pages coming from N1, what fraction of the pages that belong to N1 are going to be replaced in the upcoming epoch. And that is the weight parameter for this particular node. For instance, if it turns out that N1 has 10% of the candidate pages that are going to be replaced in the next epoch, then its weight is 0.1. If N2 is going to account for 30% of the replacements 30% of the M replacements in the upcoming epoch, then N2's weight is going to be W2 and so on. So what this initiator does is it computes this min H and it also computes the weight for each one of the nodes, and that's what is sent back to each node. So each node is going to receive the min H and also the weight for all I, meaning each node is not only receiving its own weight, that is its own fraction of the M pages that are going to be replaced, but it is also getting the fraction of the pages that are going to be replaced from each of its peer nodes in the entire cluster. And we'll see how this information is going to be used by each one of these nodes. And of course, we don't know the future. All that the initiator is doing is it is saying that this is the expected replacement. W1 is the expected share of replacement that's going to happen in N1. W2 is the expected share of replacement that's going to happen in N2 and so on. And when the next epoch starts, actually, that can be different depending on what happens in these nodes. But that's the best that we can do, is use the past to predict the future. That's what the initiator is doing. It is using the past, the age information that it got from all the nodes, in order to predict the future in terms of where these M replacements are going to happen. What is the minimum age of the pages that are going to be replaced in the next epoch? So that's what is being done by the initiator.